So please, ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Shappi Khorsandi!
Hello, everybody. Woo! You all right? My name's Shappi. And I'm originally from the 80s. And it's lovely to talk about racism, because in the 80s, racism was very different. It was very friendly back then. Do you remember? Oh, you're foreign. You'd never guess at the telephone. Oh, it used to be nice like that. And every time I went to my friend Louise's house, her dad would open the door when I was about 8 and go, "Hello, Shappi, been on holiday." So it was lovely. It's all a bit intense and weird and serious now. And my little sister didn't realise what the BNP was, because she's 20 and she doesn't really pay attention. Not that I'm saying young people don't pay attention, I just saw a very young man. Hello, I did. But no. But she was like going, "British, Britain, love Britain, national, that's all right, it's a positive word, and party, woo! Wait a minute, I'm the only one here with a natural sense of rhythm. Is this another racist organisation?" She's a bit thick. I wasn't thick at school, I was dyslexic. But they used to spell it in the 80s, T-H-I-C-K. But the good thing about it was that I always got the countdown conundrum quite quickly. And I'm like, "Guys, jumble up the letters a little bit." So I am, I'm from Iran originally, and a lot of people say to me, "Well, you know, do you feel more British or more Iranian?" I have got a British passport, and to get a British passport, I have to go to a solicitor and pledge an oath to the Queen, and they give you the holy book of your choice. So I had Winnie the Pooh. And that night I lost sleep. I thought, "I've just pledged my allegiance to the Queen and her heirs. That means if Harry or William want a favour off me, I have to do it, and I've got no idea where to buy cocaine." And people go, "But do you feel more British or do you feel more Iranian?" And I'm like, "I don't care, I'm busy." But, and then they really go off on one, people, when they want to know, they want to, you to tell them. And they go, "Okay, if England and Iran were playing football, which one would you support?" And I was like, "Well, that's obvious, I'd support Iran, because I'm British and I support the underdog." And my little boy, we've double-barreled his surname. His surname is Khorsandi Riley, and I love the fact that he has an Irish and Iranian surname. So now when Americans meet him, they won't know whether to bomb him or pretend to be related to him. It'll be fine. Although I do think with that, I think it is too soon for an election, way too soon after Celebrity Big Brother. But I'm not worried, because I think England's a very tolerant country. We're very good at being intolerant. We should be proud of that and not let it get overshadowed by these funny-looking people. But I'm a BNP. Anyway, sorry. But that was a bit BNP-ist. I don't know. I stayed in this hotel in Cornwall, and I did that thing when you stay in a B&B. They always have a Gideon Bible in the little drawer, and then it didn't have the Bible, it was missing. And I was like, okay, well, I wasn't going to read it or anything, but it's just a sweet little, you know, tradition. And I said to the receptionist, "Is that not tradition anymore?" And she goes, "Oh, it is, but when you rang up and booked, you had a funny name. So we took it out so we didn't offend you." I just thought that's very sweet, that this hotel worried that I'd be standing there pressed up against the wall going, "That book is looking at me with its eyes." I wouldn't have cared. I don't mind. You know, I wasn't raised with a religion at all growing up. My father's an atheist, which isn't as fun as it sounds. My little gerbil Fifi died when I was 8. A lot of stuff happened to me when I was 8. And I said to my dad, "Is Fifi, is she in heaven now with Louise's cat?" And my dad goes, no, Fifi's in the ground being eaten by worms." I was like, "Dad, that's awful, why?" He goes, "Oh, we worried she might block the toilet." So I didn't know anything about religions. For ages, I thought Muslims and Jewish people don't eat pork because pigs are so cute. And I thought that rabbi was the plural for rabbit. It's not. And my best friend at school was a Jewish girl, and she freaked out one day going, "Oh, I had a piece of ham by accident." I did it. I was only 18, and she was like, "Oh, my rabbi's going to kill me. My rabbi's going to kill me." I was like, "Why? Have you not cleaned the hutch?" You know. So, that's all right. I feel very positive. I read this lovely story in the paper, not the paper, the Metro, that this 10-strong gang of youths had been terrorising a neighbourhood, and they'd been caught, and their pictures were printed. And what was really lovely was that amongst them were black, Asian, and white youths. And I thought, how beautiful that this rainbow of thuggery has really stuck two fingers up at those that say multiculturalism isn't working. And of course, the BNP are letting non-whites in now, and I was thinking of joining, because to be honest with you, I'm really tired of people coming over here and taking my jobs. I was watching Channel 4 News the other day, and there was a white newsreader. I'm not gonna give up till me and Krishan Gurumurthy are presenting everything. I won't rest until the man jangling his keys outside a nightclub at 3 a.m. going, minicabs, minicabs, as Jeremy Clarkson. You know. It's nice. We're a good country. We're a tolerant country. That's a nice thing. Sometimes a little bit too much. When I first met my husband, he's English-ish, and he read in some book about Iranian culture to learn about my culture, and he read that it's the custom for Iranian men to kiss on greeting each other, and he got a little bit over-enthusiastic with my father, and after that, every time he came over, my dad would hide behind the curtains, going, I feel dirty, get him away from me. When our little son was born, we were in the hospital, and the midwife came along with a little clipboard, and she goes, what's the ethnicity of your child? And I looked at my baby boy and I said, well, if I had to guess, I'd say he's half otter, half squirrel monkey. And she goes, look, we really need to know for our records. I was like, well, he's pink. Have you not got a box for pink? And she goes, look, where are his parents from? And I said, well, we're both Middle Eastern. I'm from Iran and my husband's from Nottingham. And she goes, right, so he's mixed race. Mixed race, what does that mean? I don't know what that means. It means nothing, madam, does it? Because we're a mixture of all sorts of things. If all of us looked in our DNA, we'd be a mishmash of all sorts of different races. I don't think you should call someone mixed race unless they're very obviously mixed race, you know, like a mermaid. Because if you see a mermaid, you go, obviously someone in your ancestry got drunk on a beach, fucked a fish, and now here you are sitting on this rock, crying. And I get too PC. I do think that mermaids are an underrepresented minority in Britain. You only ever see the very beautiful ones. You never see the ones that got the fish's head and the human legs. I do get I never like to offend anybody. I met this Chinese bloke the other, you see, I nearly said Chinaman then. You can't say Chinaman, that sounds too colonial. I met a Chinaman, jolly good fellow, shot him in the eye! You can't do that. So I said to him, oh, my name's Shappi, what's your name? And he went, Comitan, and I did that very PC thing of I repeated his name and I added a Chinese accent to it to show that I cared very much about the correct pronunciation. I said, oh, I see, Comitan. He went, no, 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 call me Tom. Felt like a right twat. But this race thing's really weird. This Iranian woman came up to me after a gig once. She goes, I didn't like your comedies. Because she didn't speak like that at all. I'm just taking the piss out of her because she didn't like me. She goes, you didn't sound very proud of being Iranian. I was like, I don't really know what you mean. I just tell jokes. And she goes, well, you didn't tell the audience that we are the Aryan race. I said, well, they didn't ask. And the thing is, I got into a discussion, actually it was very scary, when I was a teenager with a guy in the National Front, which is what BNP was called in the olden days, and he said, yeah, we're Aryans and I hate fucking Pakis. And I was like, stop fucking them then. And I did explain to him. I said to him, look, you know, actually Iran is called Iran because when the Aryan race first migrated, the first country they settled in, they called Iran, which means land of the Aryans. So when I rule the world, you pasty fuckers are going to be the first to go. You've been a joy. Thank you. Good night.